Good day to all of you. Computer Shiksha is supported by. Now, all of you have almost completed this module of Paint. After this class, you will be revising what you have learned so far. After the revision, you will all appear for a practical test for this part. Let us now revise what we learned in the last class. Can you tell what is the curve tool? Curve tool functions very much like the line tool, but using the curve tool, you can bend your line twice. You can use it to do the work you want to do. Can you tell what is the difference between the line tool and the curve tool? When you use the line tool to draw a line, you cannot bend it. But a line drawn with the help of the curve tool can be bent twice, and you can use it to draw lines as well. Now, all of you switch on your computers and open the MS Paint file. In today's class, you will learn about different types of tools and will also use them to make pictures. Today, you will learn about the rounded rectangle tool and you will get to know what is a rounded rectangle tool, how can you make use of the rounded rectangle tool to make drawings? What is the pencil tool? What is airbrush tool? Using all these tools, you will make pictures of a stick, a mobile phone, a river with a boat in it, and some other such pictures. Do you know what is a rounded rectangle tool? The rounded rectangle tool is similar to the rectangle tool, but the corners in a rounded rectangle are rounded or curved. Look at the picture being shown to you and can you tell how this picture will be made? To make this picture, you will use the rounded rectangle tool and then to fill colors within it, you will use the color 1 and color 2 options. Can you make this drawing? Go ahead and make this picture. If you face a problem in making this picture, watch the video and learn from it. Let us now watch this video and see how easy it is to use the rounded rectangle tool to make this picture of a stick. So select the rounded rectangle tool, select the solid color from the fill option, and then select the color 1 and color 2. We are making color 1 black and color 2 brown. And then just drag this picture like this of a rounded rectangle which is made with black outline and is filled with the brown color. See the picture in front of you and tell what is this picture called. Yes, this is a picture of a mobile phone. Can you make this picture? Make this picture. And in case you face a problem, watch the video being shown to you. With the help of this video, let us see how we can use the rounded rectangle tool to make this nice picture of a mobile. For this, first take your pointer to the shapes and select the rounded rectangle tool. Then go to the fill option and select solid color. Make color 1 black and choose color 2 as gray, or make both black. Take the pointer to the drawing area in the paint sheet and then drag a rectangle here as is being shown in the video. It's a rounded rectangle looking like a mobile. Next, change the color to gray, because now we will make another rectangle inside which is filled with gray color. So drag it here as is being shown in the video again, like this. And if you want to adjust the placement of this rectangle, you can select it and move it slightly towards the left so that it's in the center of the black rectangle. Now let's choose the oval tool. Make color 1 also gray and then drag a small oval here to complete this picture of a mobile. So this is how you can use the rounded rectangle tool to make this nice picture of a mobile. Look at the picture now being shown to you and tell which tools have been used to make this picture. In order to make this picture, you will need to use the rounded rectangle tool, the curve tool, and the oval tool. What tool will you use to type text? In order to type, you will need to use the text tool. Can you all make this picture? Go ahead and make this picture. If you have a problem in doing this, then look at the video being shown and learn from it. Watch this video now and learn how you can use the rounded rectangle tool and other tools to make this picture. Select color 1, make it black, and then we need to select the rounded rectangle tool by clicking on it in the shapes. Bring your pointer to the drawing area in the paint sheet and drag a rounded rectangle as is being shown in the video, like this. Change the color 1 to red color, and then drag another rounded rectangle on top of the first one here, like this. And another one on the bottom of the first rounded rectangle here, like this. Help you make your drawings very easily. Next, we need to type some text in the first rounded rectangle. So we take a pointer to the text tool, click on it with the left button of the mouse or the touchpad and select that, and then drag a text box here, and then you can type within this box. Let's start typing. Draw 2 more rectangles with rounded rectangle tool. Note that since the font size, which is already selected here is quite large, 26. So your letters are becoming big. Draw two more rectangles with rounded corners. Next, drag another text tool here at the bottom and type here, as was shown in the picture, we have to type curved line for smile. Now you notice that because of the large font size, it is going out of our rounded rectangle. So we can select this text that we have just typed, go to the font size option, click on the button there, and then choose the right size that we want. Next, select that oval tool, choose solid color from the fill option, and choose color 1 as black. Color 2 also as black, or we can keep the color 2 as white because we don't want to fill it inside, and then drag an oval here, then choose color 2 black if you want to fill it with black color. Drag another oval. Note that you can always drag one oval and then copy paste the same, or like in this video, we can drag a second oval and then move it to the place where we want it. Next, we want a smiley face. So for that, we change the color 1 to red. From the fill option, choose no fill and then draw here on the side. Choose the third thickness for the thickness of this oval. Now we need to make color 2 white because we need to cut the top portion. Then from select option, choose the rectangular selection and select the top portion, and you can use Ctrl plus X to cut this. Now select the remaining portion of the curve and move it close to the eyes. If your background becomes white, you know that you have to go to the select option and select the transparent selection to correct this. Then you can put the smile in place, and this way you can complete your drawing using rounded rectangle tool and the text and oval tool. You will now learn about the pencil tool. Do you know what is a pencil tool? You can use the pencil tool to draw anything in your paint sheet, like drawing a line, drawing ovals, and writing something. You can use the pencil tool to do many other things. Let us now watch this video and learn how you can use the pencil tool to write something in your paint sheet. Let us now watch this video and learn the use of the pencil tool. You can use the pencil tool to draw something on your paint sheet and also to write any text that you like. It's like using a pencil. Select the pencil tool. Bring your pointer to the drawing area in the paint sheet. And let's draw the letter A. As is being shown in the video, it is very simple. It is just like writing with a pencil. When you are dragging, keep the left button pressed, and then you can release the button when you don't want to draw. We have changed the size, we have selected the next size, and now we are drawing a nice curved letter B. just like you would do with a pencil. Once again, we are going to change the size, select the next bigger size or the next thicker size, and then draw the letter C, which is a curved letter. Select the next bigger or thicker size, and let's draw the letter D here, like this. So this is just to practice so that you can easily use the pencil tool on your paint sheet. Next, we draw the letter E, like this. And here, from the top, and in the middle, select a different color. Let's see what happens when we use the pencil with a deep brown color. And let's draw the letter F. So here is the letter F. Let's now change the thickness. We select the thinnest line, change the color also to green. Then we can draw a letter G. It's a fancy letter. So this is how we can use the pencil tool to draw text and other lines. Next, you all will learn about the brush tool. Do you know what is the brush tool? Using the brush tool, you can change your drawing into different designs. You can also draw anything using the brush tool. There are many types of brushes, and you will get to know about all of these. Now, all of you use the brush tool to write your name. Let us learn by watching this video about how you can make use of the brush tool. With the help of this video, we will now see how you can use different types of brushes to draw or write something in your paint sheet. When you click on the drop-down button in brushes, you can see many brushes are there. So let's select one by one each of these brushes and see how a drawing with this brush looks like. So let's write the letter A with the first brush that we have selected. You can see that it's a relatively thin brush. Let's change the color to red and let's select the second brush, and you can see it is a different type of brush. Let's write the letter B with this. Select the next brush. You can see the differences here, and we are writing the letter C with this brush. Select the fourth brush. Let's change the color to blue, dark blue, and write the letter D using this brush, like this. So, by using these different brushes, you are seeing the different types that you can use. We have selected the next brush, the fifth brush. It's a relatively thick brush, and we are typing or we are writing the letter E with it. Change the color once again. Let's select the next brush, which is the sixth brush, and let's write the letter F with it. So you can see each brush is giving you different kinds of writing. We are using the seventh brush now by selecting it, and this is an even thicker brush. We are writing the letter G with it. The next brush is like a pencil. It's a very thin brush, and we can write the letter H with it to see how it looks. The last brush is again a thick brush. Let's change the color once again and let's write the letter I with it. So this way you can try out different brushes and see how to use the brush tool. Look at the picture in front of you and tell how can you make this picture. To make this picture, you will need to use the oval tool, the line tool, the pencil tool, and the color 1 and color 2 options. Can you make this picture? Go ahead and make this picture. In case you face a problem, take help by watching the video. Let us watch this video and learn how we can make this colorful picture of a sailboat in the sea. So for this, we first need to select the rectangle tool. Then let's select color 1. First let's select the fill option and use the solid color option to fill in. Select color 1 as this light blue color, the color of the sky. Let's also select color 2 as the same color, light blue color, because we are now going to drag a solid rectangle having the color which is the same as the boundary. So we bring a pointer to the drawing area in our paint sheet and drag this rectangle as is being shown in the video. Like this. Next, let's start by making the sun in this picture. So for that, we need to select the oval tool by clicking on the oval shape. And then let's change color 1 to the yellow color, the color of the sun. Also, let's change color 2 to the same color, yellow. We bring our pointer to this place on the top left inside our rectangle and drag this oval here to make the sun. Next, we need to make the boat which will be in the sea. So we again will use the oval tool, but let's use a different color. Let's change color 1 to red. Let's also change color 2 to red so that we can drag a solid oval to make the boat. So we bring our pointer to a position here on the lower side of the rectangle and drag this oval here. Now remember, we need to cut the top portion of the oval so that we have a proper boat. So before doing that, we should change the color to, we are not changing it to white this time because the background is sky blue. We are changing color to sky blue. Otherwise, if we change it to white, then the top portion which we cut will be in white. So from the select tool, select the rectangular selection. Bring your pointer here so that you can select the top portion of this red oval. As is being shown in the video. And after selection, you can just use Ctrl plus X, which is the shortcut command to cut. Once you have done that, you can select the remaining portion of the red oval and move it slightly downwards where our boat should be. Next, let's make the mast on this boat. A mast which holds the sails on the boat. So for that, we change the color 1 to light brown color. And we need to select the line tool. So we select the line tool. Change the size of the line. Let's choose the thickest size. And then from this point to the boat, we just make this line here, which is the mast for the sails. On top of this, we need to make a thinner line. So we select the thinner size and then make a small line on top of this mast. Like this. From here till here. Now we need to make the sails of the boat. For this, let's use the pencil tool. So to use the pencil tool, we need to first take a pointer to the toolbox and select the pencil tool by clicking on it. Left click with your mouse or the touchpad. Choose the right size of the line, the thickness. We have chosen the thin line and draw a line like this. And then from here a little downwards, slanting down like this. And another line here. And then we can join it to the mast. Like this. And the last line. Here. Like this. Next, let's change the color of these lines to draw the lines of the sail inside this portion. We've already selected the line. We are just selecting a different size now, slightly thicker, and we choose the blue color for this line. We are changing the color to blue by clicking on that color, and then we draw the lines here and here as is being shown in the video. Next, we need to fill in the sail with colors. So we select the brown color as color 1, or first let's make this line here so that the sail joined to the mast. Now we select the fill with color option and select a color, grayish color, to fill here. Bring the pointer here and fill the color. Bring the pointer this side and fill the color here also. And in the middle, let's change the color and fill a different color. So we've chosen red for this. Fill the color here also, like this. Now we will be making the sea waves, the water waves. So we select one of the brushes. We can select any. Let us, for this drawing, let's select the airbrush option. Once we have selected the airbrush, we can change the color to the color that we need. So we use dark blue and then we just draw these lines here with the brush. As you can see in the video, like you normally use a crayon or a color pencil to color, we are going to use this brush tool to fill the color here. This should be easy for you. You can use the brush and keep coloring in this area so that the sea looks dark blue and the sky is light blue here. So like this, we can continue and fill in the color as is being shown in the video. Let's also add some white color in this so that we can see that there are some bubbles in the sea also. So after using the airbrush with blue color, dark blue color, we change the color and we choose the white color with the same airbrush, and we are now making the white waves also appearing in the sea. So this is how you can make this beautiful picture. Since today's class ends here, all of you close your paint file and properly shut down your computer. In today's class, all of you learned what is the rounded rectangle tool, how you can use the rounded rectangle tool to make pictures, what is the pencil tool, what is the airbrush tool. And using all these tools, you drew a stick, a mobile phone, and a river with a boat in it. Also, using the brush tool and the pencil tool, you made some other pictures. Computer Shiksha is supported by... Thank you.